जय हो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम रत्नाकर सूर्यवंशी फ्रॉम एसके पब्लिक स्कूल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू लेसन, आई मीन द सेकेंड लेसन इन पॉलिटिकल साइंस, दैट इज फेडरलिज्म। देन कॉमनली अ क्वेश्चन अराइजेस, व्हाट वी लर्न इन दिस लेसन, करेक्ट नो? सो इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न मीनिंग ऑफ फेडरलिज्म। फर्स्ट वी लर्न द मीनिंग ऑफ फेडरलिज्म एंड देन we are going to learn the key features of federalism. We are going to learn the key features of federalism. But in between the meaning and key feature, even we are going to learn about two forms of government. I mean two forms of government. For example, just I am telling you, we consider as unitary form of government as well as federal form of government. About those also we are going to learn in this chapter, and even we are going to learn after the key features of federalism, we are going to learn about the two roots of creation of federals, the two roots of creation of federations we consider here. For example, importantly I'll tell you those coming together federations and holding together federations. So about those also we are going to learn in this, as well as after this we are going to learn about what makes India a federal country. I mean, what are the factors make India a federal country? So about those factors also we are going to learn. After that we are going to learn about how federalism is practiced in our country, I mean how federalism is practiced in India. About those reasons, about those important factors, points also we will learn in this chapter. And at the end of this lesson, we are going to learn the decentralization. This is decentralization. At the end of this lesson, we are going to learn about the decentralization. So here in this lesson, I mean at the end, as I told you, the decentralization in India we are going to learn. So it is decentralization is, you know, it is 5 mark question. It is 5 mark question remaining here. I mean meaning if we take, it is 1 mark question, and key features obviously 3 mark or 5 mark question. Key features of federalism and two roots of creation of federation. Two roots, as I told you, coming together and holding together. This is also obviously it carry 3 marks. Or sometime it may be asked for 5 marks. And then, as I told you, how federalism is practiced in India, obviously that is for 5 marks. And as well as what makes India a federal country, what are the reasons, what are the factors taken to consider India a federal country, so that is also for 5 marks. So this is the overall weightage of concept wise of the federalism. So let's start this lesson with its meaning. First we will learn the meaning of federalism. In this we will learn the meaning of federalism. Then what is the meaning? Obviously you have learnt in 9th as well as in 8th also, you have learnt common meaning. One general meaning of federalism means, you know, that existence of more than one level of government is called as federalism, correct? No, but here we are going to add more meaning to the word federalism. We are going to add more meaning to the word federalism. Then what is the meaning of federalism in this year? See, federalism is a system of government. Federalism is a system of government in which the power is divided between a central authority and various constituent units of the country. I repeat, Federalism is a system of government in which the power is divided between the central authority and various constituent units of the country. So this is the actual meaning of federalism. For example, if we take India only, see, India is a federal country. Why? Because see, India has two, commonly 3 levels of government, but mainly we consider 2. central government and state government. Third one is local self government. But at least two we can find in India. Why? Because India is a federal country, and in India, central government also has its own powers, as well as in the same way state governments also has its own particular powers, and this is what we call federalism. So this is the actual meaning of federalism. Next, we are going to learn about the two forms of government. So those two forms of government are unitary form of government and federal form of government. Unitary form first. See, in the unitary form of government, there is an existence of central government, but there may be existence of state government or may not be the existence of state government. But the power, major powers are exercised by the central government, and the powers to the state are given by the central government only in the unitary form of government. And central government can withdraw at any time the powers given to the state government. So this is what we call unitary form of government. And see here, commonly we can consider in the unitary form of government, most of the powers are vested with central government, not with state government. There may be existence of state government, but state governments are subordinate to the central government, and they have to do whatever the order given by the central government. That is what we call unitary system of government. But in federal system, central government cannot order the state government to do something, because state government has power of its own, which is not answerable to the central government. State government in federal system, state government has its own power, and it is not responsible, it is not answerable to whom? To the central government. So these are the two forms of government, which are those unitary system of government or unitary form of government, as well as federal system or federal form of government here. So these are the two. And in unitary form, especially in federal form of government, both the government, central government as well as state government, both are answerable to the people. Both are answerable to the people. And even one more important point also we can add here. For example, let's go back to the first lesson of political science, that is the power sharing. See, the Sri Lankan Tamils wanted Sri Lanka to become a federal country. So because of that, they had fought. And even in Belgium also, before 1993, Belgium also had a unitary form of government. Had a unitary form of government after the four amendments to the constitution between 1970 and 1993. After that, Belgium became a country of federalism. Why here? Because before the amendments of constitution also, Belgium had state governments. But those state governments were subordinate to the central government. They worked under central government, and the powers to the state governments were given by whom? By the central government. And central government could withdraw the powers given to the state governments at any time, whenever it required, whenever it wants. But after 1993, Belgium became a federal country. So this is what we call federalism, and the two forms of government. Those are unitary form of government and federal form of government. So next concept is key features of the federalism. So that topic we will take in the next class. Thank you. Jai Hind.